coming this February to Frontline. We blog, we post, we tweet, we read, we write, we play, we plot, we chat, we text, we communicate, collaborate, commiserate, and even date. More and more in the digital realm.
Things move much, much faster. There's much less time to consider what you do, and everything you do is absolutely permanent.
We have broadened our world and made more connections, but what have we lost?
Every hour of life on the screen is an hour not spent in the rest of life. If we're there, where aren't we?
Over a year ago, Frontline launched its Digital Nation website.
Even though you could technically call me a digital native, I try to be relatively tech-free.
This February, Frontline producer Rachel Dretson.
Okay, sign off.
See you soon.
And correspondent Douglas Rushkoff take you even deeper inside this cultural revolution to explore the amazing possibilities and the sobering realities of this wired world we are living in.
I don't feel like there's any distinction between the cyber and the real. This is virtual reality. Here we are.
I'm a blogger, a tweeter, a citizen of Facebook, and a resident of Second Life.
I'm connected to my BlackBerry. I need it at all times.
A 21st century explosion of information, stimulation, and constant contact. 24/7 with no restrictions.
I still feel like I'm missing something if I can't check my email.
I check it every 5 minutes, 12 times an hour, over 100 times a day.
That's pretty bad.
That is pretty bad.
Our children have grown up with this technology.
Who can read these blogs?
Anybody.
Like anybody in the world can read this?
For many people, it's unsettling because all of a sudden, your child knows more than you do.
Multitasking has become a way of life.
They are convinced that they can check their Facebook, they can instant message, they can email, and listen to what the professor is saying, all at the same time.
Digital media is creating a short attention span culture.
An office building stands empty as employees meet and collaborate in virtual worlds.
This immersive environment is much more engaging, much more human in a way.
This is Julie Reed. I'm based out of Burlington, Vermont.
I'm living in Böblingen, Germany.
I'm from São Campinas, Brazil.
And you've all met in real life at one point or another, right?
Actually, no. This is how we know each other.
Right side clear!
And even the military has transformed itself by using digital technologies for training.
This generation has an expectation that if they're going to be trained, that you're going to entertain them.
For recruiting.
Can I get an Xbox 360 controller, please?
If we want to be able to grow the United States Army, we have to be ingrained with society. Whatever society is doing, that's what the Army's going to be doing.
Die!
And even for waging war.
Going to war has meant the same thing for over 5,000 years, that you were going to a place where there was such danger that you might never see your family again. Now compare that experience to that of a Predator drone pilot. You're sitting behind a computer screen, you're shooting missiles at enemy targets, you're killing enemy combatants, and then at the end of the day, you get back in your car.
Daddy!
Hi. 20 minutes later.
We pray these things in your son, Jesus Christ, amen.
You're at the dinner table, talking to your kids about their homework.
This February, in a special broadcast, Frontline takes a critical and important look at the digital reality and our digital future.
Technology over the last, say, 50 years has mostly separated us. We've gone from watching movies together to watching them in living rooms to watching them on iPods. And I think that technology is now actually starting to bring us back together again. You're not alone anymore.
Digital Nation. Watch online or on air beginning February 2nd.